Hello friend, I am Naval. You are watching Code with Naval. Welcome to Java series part 14. In a last video we discussed about constructor. In this video we are going to discuss about instance block. So let's first understand what is the instance block. Instance block is used to initialize the instance data member. It runs each time when object create. Let's consider if you create a 5 object, if you create a 10 object, that much time this instance block execute. We use the instance block for a write a logic. That logic execute during object creation. And we use the instance block for a initialize instance variable. If we talk about constructor and instance block difference, the constructor and instance block both are execute object creation. But first instance block execute, then constructor execute. You can see in example, we simply use a block for a writing an instance block. So let's move on to Eclipse and we will going to perform a practical. So let's create one class here. I'll simply create here one class and give the class name part 14. Okay. Now we have to create one main method. Okay, let's create one main method. Now we can create an instance block in an instance area. Okay, simply we have to, for creating an instance block, we use a open bracket and close bracket, and we can write anything inside that instance block. I'll simply write here as system.out.println instance block. Instance block. Okay, instance block. We can write simply. Now we have to create object. As we saw, during object creation, this instance block execute. Okay, this instance block initialize. Okay, let's create one object. I'll simply create one object part 14 pt equal to new part 14. Okay, you can see here our object is created. Now let's run this program. You can see here instance block execute. Okay, you can see here instance block execute. Now I'll create one constructor, one zero argument constructor. Okay, simply create here zero argument constructor public part 14. And this is our zero argument constructor. I'll simply print here system.out.println zero argument constructor. Okay. Now let's run program again. And you can observe here our instance block execute first, then our zero argument constructor execute. We can define one more instance block after this constructor. Here we can define one more block, and inside that block I'll simply define instance block 2. Okay, instance block 2, and this one is the instance block 1. Let's save this, run this. Now you can observe first our instance block 1 execute, then our instance block 2, and then execute this constructor. Okay, we can do one more thing. We can define one more constructor here with the parameterized constructor. I'll simply define here public part 14, and simply we pass here parameter int a comma int b. Okay, simply perform here addition system.out.println and we can say here two argument constructor, and then here perform addition. Okay, a plus b. Okay, let's save this. Now we have to call this constructor. We have to create object for this constructor. I'll simply define here new. Okay, we can create a nameless constructor, nameless object also directly. Okay, in this way, here we simply pass 10 comma 20. Okay, let's save this. Here we have two object. First one is the name object. Here we define a name. This object, here we define a name, but second one is a nameless object. Okay, in this way we can define a nameless object. Let's save this, run this. You can see here we have a two object, this first one pt and this second one nameless object. Okay, let's, you can see here when our first object execute, that time first this instance block execute, the first instance block, then second instance block, then execute this first constructor. In the same scenario, in a second two argument constructor, when we call a two argument constructor, that time also first execute this instance block, then this instance block, then execute this constructor. Okay, as we know, here we saw in a definition, we use instance block for initialize variable. You can see this third point, initialize variable. So let's declare some instance variable. I'll simply define here string name, and this is empty. Let's correct the spelling. String name, then int age. Okay, this two variable. We didn't initialize those variable. Now we can use this block for initialize those variable. We can simply define here name equal to, I'll simply give my name, name equal to Naval. Okay, you can see, and this second one is the age equal to 24. Okay, we can say 24. Let's save this. Now we can print those variable inside a constructor. For that, I'll simply define here sysout. Okay, and here name colon equal to that, append that name variable, and then again here append age dash equal to age. Okay, now you can see here we define a two instance variable. Those variable we initialize inside this instance block. Here we simply assign those variable value, then call this constructor. Inside a constructor we simply print those variable value. Okay, let's save this, run this. You can see here first instance block execute. When execute this instance block, those variable assign a value. Okay, then instance block 2 execute, then this constructor execute. Now we have to define here space. Okay, in this way, let's run. You can see first execute instance block 2, then this constructor. Inside of this constructor we simply print those instance variable. As we discussed earlier, whatever time of object we create, that much time those instance block execute. Okay, you can see here we simply create a two time object. That means every time this instance block execute, when we create a first object, that time also those instance block execute. When we create a second time object, that time also those two instance block execute. We use the instance block for initialize instance variable value. Okay, that's it. Let's here we define a two instance block and then two constructor. In each constructor execution time, those instance block execute first, then execute constructor. So I hope you understand what is the instance block. For this video, that's it. We will see next topic in the next video. Till that, bye bye.